Hello, we are here at 8020 Temptation Lane. It is March 26th. We're going to walk through and we're going to give you some suggestions on what I think needs to be done to the property in order to get us the most rent that we could possibly get in today's market. So you'll notice here that we've got an attached two-car garage, which is absolutely wonderful. We are also located at the end of what I would call a cul-de-sac within the townhome community. No extra parking in front of your unit here. However, I will show you an area as we walk to the front door where there is some extra parking. All of this is maintained by the association, so we do not need to worry really anything about this. So as things grow in, weeds, things being trimmed, all of it's being dealt with by the HOA. These solar screens that you see on this unit are really not necessary. It makes the unit look dark and a little smaller. So I'm gonna request that John remove all of these solar screens. That's the only one that I say can stay. It's a secondary bedroom window because there really will be some western sun that comes in on that. However, if it gets removed, it's not that big of a deal. So all these definitely will be removed. Some pretty rose bushes that will be all taken care of by the HOA, which is great. They're just starting to bloom. Okay, that's extra parking. I pulled up today and I was concerned about parking, but in reality there were two additional spots that were open. So my feeling is when guests are coming here, there should always be a spot open. And then since the unit itself has a two-car garage, the tenants themselves will be fine. They'll be able to park their cars in there. This has a cute little courtyard that can be decorated however the tenant wants it to be. We have a screen door here, which is nice. They can leave the door itself open and then they can let fresh air in. So this is the interior of our townhome. However, I am not excited about this paint color. So it's got a very peachy color to it. It's got some areas where it needs some good painting anyways. So what I am suggesting that the entire unit get what we call an executive paint job, which is a two-tone paint. These walls will become more of a biscotti, like a light tan color, and then the baseboards will get a nice fresh coat of white paint. Door trims will stay white, ceilings will stay white. That way it gives you a real executive feel. That's why we call it the executive paint job. We are gonna remove this kind of something or another that they put on this window. It's kind of, it looks clothy, but it might just be a, well, I guess it's, I don't know, rice paper that they put up there. That's all gonna come off. So we are not planning on putting blinds up there because it's not a privacy issue. We are just going to remove that so it goes back to a natural window. All the blinds seem to be in pretty good shape, so we don't need to worry about that. In the living room, it's really just about paint. Now, here is our kitchen. As you walk through the front door, this is the first thing that you see. So what I want to do is I want to update this kitchen to where it is kind of a wow factor. This is a Formica white countertop. I would like to change this out to be granite. The cabinets are this kind of 1980s, what we would call natural wood. I would like to paint them white. That way it's got a really good fresh white coat of paint. The appliances right now are all black. That's going to be great. We'll utilize that. And we will get rid of this fridge and we will put in a black fridge. So just imagine this kitchen with black and white granite countertop. We are going to put in a new sink. We'll probably be able to use this faucet. However, I'm having John with Sell Ready quote us on what I call a farmer's sink. It is very trendy. It would be a huge wow factor for this kitchen. It is actually a one basin sink, much deeper than a normal sink. It is something that everybody is going cuckoo over. So if we can do that in this kitchen pretty easily, I think that it's definitely something to look at in the bid. So you're gonna get an option for just a normal sink, and then you're gonna get the option for a farmer sink. We also need to update the lighting in here. So we're gonna go ahead and get rid of this box. We're gonna flush this to the ceiling, and then we're gonna install a minimum of 4 recessed or can lights. And then we would like to put one more can light over the kitchen sink. We will have this GFI become a switch for that particular can light. So the normal two-way switches over here will turn on the four can lights. That light switch over there will turn on this one. So then that way your kitchen gets a kind of just an overall facelift, which I think will be really nice. The kitchen does roll into the laundry room, which is a really good size laundry room for this particular size of a townhome. So we've got a washer dryer. We have some good storage over there. I would probably utilize that as a pantry since it's so close to the kitchen. That way you can put your canned goods in there, put your extra crock pot in there. This is a really nice storage element for this floor plan. In here we have a garage, again mentioned, two-car garage, which is awesome. That way the tenants will be able to park their car and then have direct access into the unit. You guys can't smell this because you're on a video, you can only see it, but I'm guaranteeing you it smells like a cigarette in here. So somebody has been loving the fact that they smoke here in the garage. I mentioned that on the video only so that it reminds me that there was a smoke smell in this garage before we put a tenant in the property. We don't need to do anything about cleaning this up or neutralizing the smell. It's a garage. Nobody really cares. And then once the garage door goes up and the wind comes in, all of the smell goes out anyways. We will have John do a power wash on this floor. It does have a slight epoxy finish, so I think this will get cleaned up really nicely. And then, of course, when the tenants move in, it'll get dirty again with all their cars, but during the showing period, it'll look really nice. Love the extra storage that we have in here. We will remove that soft water system. John will go ahead and remove the whole element and cap it off. The inspection will tell you how old this is. I know these components look newer, but I don't know if this is actually newer. So just bear in mind, we want to make sure that we note this. I don't know why. I guess this is where you just put on a hose if you want to drain it. Is that what you do, John? Mm-hmm. All right, this is also super cool too. Storage is always a plus in any unit, townhomes especially, because they don't usually give you too much storage. So this is great if you've got suitcases, Christmas trees, things that you don't really want to waste in big storage inside the unit. Now you can store it out here. So I like that a lot. So that's a very nice feature. All right, so in here, remember, it's just going to be power washing the flooring, even though it's got a pretty strong odor of cigarette. I'm not really worried about it from a rental standpoint. All right, so I think that covers the downstairs. I did mention this, but I actually like that light fixture, so we'll keep that. This is a unique chandelier, so I like it. I mean, it's going to be, some people are going to hate it, but I actually think it's pretty cool, and it does match every other kind of light fixture that goes on upstairs, so we'll keep it. We have something going on with the electricity, so I can't turn it on right now, but I'm sure when it's on, it probably looks really pretty. So in here we have our half bath. In our half bath, I am choosing not to recommend painting these white. The only cabinets that are going to be requested for a paint is going to be in the kitchen. So if I were to paint this white, it would actually make this countertop look too yellow. So we're going to actually leave it the way that it is. I am going to get rid of these though. That is definitely dated. So we'll put in some chrome little circular towel holders. And then that'll match the faucet and the light in here. So really, that's what we'll do. But once it gets a fresh paint, that half bath will look really nice. Carpet is actually a good quality carpet. Once it gets cleaned, it should look really good. Again, we won't have these peach walls. We'll have a really nice biscotti wall, which will accent this carpet, which will be good. In this hallway, this ceiling does need to get painted. I do want to show, we have a little bit of a water mark here, maybe coming from a condensation line from the AC. That is something that the inspection report will get a little bit more detailed on. Like John said, though, if it's not a big deal, we could put some keels on it, we'll paint over it, then we can keep a good close eye on it. If there's anything that pops up in the future, then we could dig a little deeper and make sure that we fix it. Condensation lines are weird. Sometimes they'll show up with leaks and then years will go on and you won't have any problems. It all depends on the humidity in the air. This is our master, good size. Window that overlooks the front, which is always nice. Ceiling fan hangs a little low. People won't realize that until they move in, so I'm not going to worry about it. But I'm only 5'2", and I'm pretty close to touching it. So if I'm like 6 foot, this thing's going to hit my head. They'll probably put a bed right here. Again, if they want us to remove it when they move in, we can do it. Right now for the showing factor, we'll just make sure all the light bulbs match and then reinstall it. Because I think you have to leave that long of a, in order for the vaulted ceiling, right, John? Yeah, so we'll leave it and see what the tenant says. If it becomes a problem for them, then I can, one, remove the light kit and just leave the ceiling fan, or we can completely remove the ceiling fan and cap it once they move in, if they say anything. The odds of them saying anything are probably slim to none, and Slim just left town, so that should be okay. Hey, I didn't see this when I walked through before, but do you see this?
I was looking at it right now, actually.
Yeah, I didn't see that before, and there's something along the ceiling line, too.
Yeah,
so
I'll look at that.
We'll need to make that look a little bit better when the time comes. I think that might be wallpaper that they painted over. That could be what that is.
It's called elephant. Are you still taping it?
Yes, she never stops.
I got a close up.
So it's like elephant because it's got the wiggles and the.
Yeah, so.
Don't you think that looks like wallpaper?
That's exactly what it is. My downstairs bathroom has it. I wiped it.
Okay.
And then we glazed it.
So what we'll need to do is make this look a little bit better when you do the full paint. Okay. In here, we
Thank
have
you.
The master bath.
Thank you for your input.
The walk-in closet is right here. You know, good functioning walk-in closet. We have a tub shower combo. We will remove this shower curtain. We'll leave the shower rod, but we'll get rid of this. Again, same issue here. We're not gonna mess with these cabinets. We've got newer faucets that are all chrome. We do wanna get rid of the fist pump. I'm not sure why we have that in here. It looks a little weird. Over here, when Taylor shows you, it's a toilet roll hanger that is right here by the sink. Very strange. We are going to get rid of both those and put up some nice silver rings. In here, it's your, you know, master toilet. Nothing to really write home about. Love that the ceramic tile does go through all the wet areas. Ceramic tile is a little bit dated, but we're going to help it out by putting the white cabinets downstairs in the kitchen. Once we get the pretty paint on the walls, it will help a little bit with this the ceramic tile, making it to where it's not quite so dated. So it'll look good. Love the vaulted ceilings in here, though. I think that's nice. A little bit of extra towel closet space that you have right here. Now, this is bedroom number 2. It does have a closet. It is a pretty good-sized bedroom. We imagined that bed will go there, TV or entertainment center will go over here. We will get rid of the DIY special lighting job. That should not be there. We're not even going to worry about why they did it. We'll just unplug it, fix it, and this room doesn't have any overhead lights, but somebody can just figure out how to put in a standing light, and that outlet right there will be a flip-on, flip-off switch to one of these outlets, and they'll be fine. So I'm not worried about that. Smoke detectors look a little old, so John's going to check all those, and the ones that are not working or a little past its prime, we are going to install newer smoke detectors. A newer one's here in the hallway. That one looks to be a little old. This is bedroom number 3. Bedroom number 3 also has a weird DIY lighting job, which we will get rid of. Unfortunately, we've got a crack in the mirror closet door. I love mirror closet doors, but once they crack, they become a liability, so we're going to remove those. John's going to install solid white closet doors. So this room will have a little different feel because this will actually be just a solid white closet door, not mirrored. This is that bedroom that I spoke of when I was outside. If the solar screens stay on this window, that will not hurt my feelings because this is about the only window that really does need a solar screen because it's direct west, and that sun for about 3 hours will be in this room before it hits that roof line next door. These are kind of cute. So I see a lot of cute opportunities on this. This has a direct access to a bathroom. So this is a mini master. So basically two masters upstairs. Again, not gonna worry about cabinets. Oh, we are gonna replace those light bulbs because those are about the ugliest things I've ever seen. And then in here, we're just gonna clean that light. This is a pretty standard shower head, so we're not messing with that. Really in here, it's just, we'll leave it other than the painting. So the painting will be done in here on the walls. Now a thought, You were probably walking through this and you may or may not have thought about this, but we have no true guest bathroom up here. We have a bathroom directly attached to this bedroom. We have a bathroom directly attached to the master. So if I was staying in that room as a guest, I don't have access to a bathroom. So there's good and bad to that. The good is I'm going to only rent to somebody that is probably going to utilize two rooms and make that an office. The other side of it is, if somebody wants it to have access to a bathroom, you could make it happen easily. You're just going to lose a lot of wall space in that third bedroom. So in reality, this is, in my opinion, a two-bedroom and a den. Even though it does have a closet, you are really going to appeal to people who need two bedrooms and a den. Two bedrooms and an office, two bedrooms and a nursery maybe, but it is really not going to be usable for three full bedrooms, in my opinion. Do not think it will mess with our rental amount as of right now, because this is such a desirable community, has so many amenities. The floor plan itself is pretty good everywhere else. Just wanted to make note of that on the video. I think I have hit all of the areas. There was one thing I didn't show you downstairs. I'll just talk about it now. The front door has a chrome deadbolt and it has a gold doorknob. That looks cheesy. So we are going to leave the chrome and then match the doorknob to the deadbolt. The rest of these throughout the house are perfectly fine. This is just the front door that we are dealing with that we will change out. And then that'll be a rekey option, which we should be rekeying anyway since we don't know the history of the property. All right, so that's this lovely Allure townhome. Hopefully I have gone over everything for you.
Do you have anything to add?
I'm good.
Okay, thank you.